In today's support system tutorial, we're diving into email templates and variables. We'll start by locating email templates within the admin panel, emails tab, templates. Support system contains a stock template set of messages that are sent out to both agents and end users as alerts and notices or auto responses during a ticket's lifecycle. These events include when a new ticket is created and when new messages are posted, as well as additional ticket and task updates. Under each template, you will see a description of when it's sent. Auto responses and alerts and notices are enabled in a separate section of the admin panel, which I will review later. These templates can be edited from here, disabled globally from here, as well as cloned and assigned to different departments. You can also create an unlimited number of email template sets. This is great for multi-branding as it allows you to have specific template sets based on the ticket or tasks department. To start, we will go through these stocked support system templates, and later I will show you how to create and assign new templates. The templates are separated into three sections. The top is for users, the middle are for agents specific to tickets, and the last are for agents specific to tasks. To make changes to a template, you will simply select the title of the template you would like to edit. Templates are editable from top to bottom, including the subject and body. Each template has an HTML-rich text toolbar for design and brand flexibility. This means that you can insert images, videos, links to external websites, edit the text layout, and more. You can also edit the pre-existing links. For example, this link directs the user to the ticket. When selecting a link, then edit, I can change the link's URL, or I can change the type of link that is sent to the user. End user ticket link will directly link the user to the ticket. End user login link will require the user to log in to view the ticket. You can also remove this link altogether if needed, depending on how you encourage your users to stay up to date with tickets. You can also include variables within templates to pull information specific to the ticket or user. You can add a variable name to all fields in the help desk and can utilize them in canned responses and email templates. Template variables utilize the type ahead feature, so to populate available variables, simply type percent, curly bracket, to initiate the variable type ahead, and then select the variable name. To give you a better understanding of how to create and use variables, we will go to the Forms tab where variables are created. You can select any form of your choice to add custom fields and name their variables. For this example, we will go to the Ticket Details form, which is associated with every ticket created. First, I will create a field by naming it and selecting the field type. Next, I will name the variable. When naming a variable, you will always want to use a custom name specific to the field. Once complete, you can save changes. Now, when I go back to the email template, I can include this variable name that I created by typing percent, curly bracket, then the variable name. When saving changes, you may be presented with an error, but this can be disregarded as long as you are sure that you've entered the proper variable name corresponding with the form field. Now, when a user creates a ticket and enters in their account number as prompted, the information they input here will be automatically included in their email response. Now that you know how to edit templates, as well as how to create and use variables, we can dive deeper into how to create custom templates to associate with specific departments. This is helpful if you would like to have different template sets associated with each department, such as HR, support, sales, etc. This is also great for multi-brand use, or if you're communicating with people of different languages. To accomplish this, we will first create a new template set by going back to Templates and selecting Add New Template Set. You will name the set, enable it, then select the set you would like to clone. Once additional sets are created, you will see them available from the drop-down here. Once complete, you will save changes and start editing the templates as needed. When you are done editing templates, you will go to Departments to associate this template set with a specific department. Once this final step is complete, users will receive auto responses specific to the department that their ticket is in. There are additional template sets located within the agent and user configurations of the admin panel settings page. You will see them by selecting both agents or users, then templates. These are messages sent during the creation of accounts, password resets, and guest ticket access links. You can also edit the information listed within certain pages in the user portal, such as the sign-in page, the email confirmation page, and the account confirmed page. You can edit any of these templates from top to bottom. And lastly, I will show you where auto responses and alerts and notices are configured. Located within the admin panel, settings tab, tickets, you will see the Autoresponder tab and Alerts and Notices tab. Autoresponses are sent to users, and Alerts and Notices are sent to agents. From these tabs, you can globally enable or disable specific alerts. Furthermore, you can disable alerts locally. This can be accomplished in a few different places. Within the Help Topic New Ticket Options tab, you can disable new ticket autoresponses. Within the department, you can disable autoresponses and alerts and notices. At the agent level, under the Department Access tab, you can disable alerts per department as needed. You can also create ticket filters to set specific criteria in tickets that must be matched prior to disabling autoresponses. And that's everything you need to know when getting started with email templates and variables. You can check out our documentation at docs.supportsystem.com for additional details on these features. Or as always, please feel free to reach out to us via email or phone. Thank you for choosing Support System to make happy customers.